Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of MySQL Server on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to install MySQL Workbench. So first you need to go to your favorite browser and then you need to search over here MySQL download and hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.mysql.com as a first search result. So to click on this MySQL download and it's going to redirect to the official site of MySQL. Here you need to scroll down and then you need to click on this MySQL community GPL downloads. And that's going to automatically redirect to this MySQL community download page. Here you'll see MySQL installer for Windows. So you need to click on that and it's going to redirect to this page. MySQL community downloads. Here you can see the latest version is version 8.0.38 at the time of making of this video. So here you need to scroll down and you'll get two installer. One is the community one, another is web community. So I'll always recommend you to download the community one. So just simply click on this download button. And here you need to just simply click on no thanks, just start my download, and you can see that a file is rightly started downloading, and you can see it will take about 23 seconds. So I have already downloaded it, so I'll go to my download directory and you can see that my exe is already been downloaded over here. So you need to just simply double click on it to start launching our MySQL installer. So here you need to just simply click on install anyway. And there you go, MySQL installer is rightly open. So let's first minimize our download directory and it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And it will again going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And there you go, MySQL installer 1.6 is rightly open. So here I'll always recommend you to click on custom and click on next. So here expand MySQL server, then MySQL, just simply click on MySQL server and click on this arrow to make it listed under product to be installed. And similarly do the same for applications as well. So just simply expand MySQL workbench, select the product and click on that arrow to get listed it under product to be installed. Similarly, you can do it for MySQL shell or router as well. I'll just simply move the shell to be under product to be installed and then I'm going to just simply click on next. So see, all these three products are going to be installed. Just simply click on execute and there you go. You can see our installation is rightly began. Rightly done, click on next. So now our product configuration page, so it need to be configured, click on next. And here you need to keep everything as default and then you need to click on next. Here also you need to keep everything as default and click on next. And here you need to provide one password. So let's provide one password. You can also create one user also if you want. So let's give a root password. So I'll just simply type root. I'll repeat the same in our repeat password as well and click on next. So this is going to be our Windows service name, which is totally fine. Click on next. So here also you need to keep everything as default. Click on next and there you go. So you need to execute these configurations. So again, it's going to take a couple of minutes. After that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. So now you can clearly see all the steps are rightly performed and you can just simply click on finish now. So just simply click on next and finish. So our MySQL workbench is rightly started launching and it has rightly launched. So let's maximize this. So let's connect to our root user. So just simply repeat that same password, which is root. So I'll just simply type that and I'm going to save this password in vault and click on OK. So MySQL workbench is rightly open. Here you can write simple queries and you can start working on your SQL projects. So that's basically all about this video. Please do let me know in this comment sections whether these videos are really helping you and if you need more videos on MySQL. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.